Guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Stephanie, and today we're going to be reviewing the movie Artemis Fowl. Is a movie about a 12-year-old kid whose father had been kidnapped. His father was like an antique dealer and like someone who dealt in really rare artifacts. And this whole movie started with like chaos, absolute chaos. We got the media all up in their grill saying, oh my god, was he like a thief stealing like this rare artifact from all over the world and things like that. So we're like, okay, cool. The movie goes on to show us that Artemis Fowl is actually a criminal mastermind and he's supposed to help get his father back. Someone calls his house, which is called the Fowl Manor, and basically says, oh, you have to get me something called the Oculus or your father dies. And being that he's smart, he was supposed to go figure it out. So he comes up with this really insane plan to get this artifact. Turns out the artifact is actually of fairy, like it's of fairy indigene. it came from the fairies. It's actually their life source. It's like the beginning of their magic. So he goes on to like make this elaborate plan to get one, at least all he needed at first was like just a fairy, and he wanted to get one of them to get him to be able to like get the whole thing for him. Bottom line, there's this whole huge thing. It's like the whole fairy police squad come up into his manor and all of that, and then they come and okay, he sort of like made the whole thing go around and use them to get to find this artifact. He finds it and uses it to get his dad back. So that being the story, I think let's talk. So for now, I think we're just going to have to talk about characters. So we'll do Artemis first. So Artemis is tagged as this criminal mastermind, the 12-year-old. He's very, very, very smart. Okay, he's smart, but how? We didn't see it. You only just told us. I mean, this kid sat down in a counselor's office in the beginning of this movie, being like, the whole idea of him being smart is being built, right? They're saying, oh, he did not need to go to school. He loved Ireland, but he did not need to go to school because he was really smart. He had cloned the goats and all of that, but I didn't see that in the entire movie. Like, if you're going to tell me a character is smart, I want to see it. I literally want to see this kid breaking codes. I want to see him. Like, all this kid did was sit down in front of a computer and trying to decipher fairy language, and that was it. Like, I didn't see his intellect play out. It was just not there. Next, let's talk about Officer Shorty. The actor who played Officer Shorty, in my opinion, looked really, really scared. You know, when you start something at the beginning and you still have like these jitters at the beginning, but the more you go through it, you end up being like calm. I didn't get that vibe from her. I felt like she was nervous, or she was like constrained. It didn't feel like she was actually acting. It felt like you know when you act a really good movie and you can't tell if the person's acting because the person has actually inhibited the character so well. She did not do that for me. I could literally tell she was acting, like she was a kid trying so hard to act, and I was not a fan of that. Then let's talk about the character of Mulch Diggins, which was played by Josh Gad. Mulch Diggins is this overgrown dwarf who has this ability to dig through anything, and he's obsessed, like all dwarves are, he's obsessed with getting treasures. So that makes him like a criminal. And I'm just like, could they have fleshed out that character a little bit more? First of all, he had like the weirdest accent. Secondly, like, I was trying to do this bad guy accent because he was like kind of like the narrator for the movie. I was not here for it. It did not make sense to me. Then he ended up having this look that looked like a poor version of Hagrid. I mean, Hagrid was poor in Harry Potter, but still, it just looked like a low budget Hagrid, and it was not fun. Then let's talk about the character of Domavoy Butler, who happens to be the family butler, whose surname is Butler but should never be called a butler. Weird. But here's the thing. This is a character who was built to have so many credentials. Like, he could fight. He could do everything. He had gone to Tokyo to learn to Tokyo, right? But and it's someplace in Japan. He had learned how to, like, fight and all of that. And my dude did not fight. I'm sorry. In the entire movie, he barely did anything. Like, all he did was use this huge bull, sculpted bull, to, like, hit the giant when it came into the house. It made no sense to me. I mean, if you're going to build a character to be this killing machine, it should actually feel like a killing machine. He did not. Then let's talk about the character of Juliet Butler, who happened to be the niece of Domavoy Butler. So this character was brought on with intention to help Artemis, because at the time, while the whole plan was going on, Artemis could not, like, he technically, Artemis is only smart, and he doesn't know how to, like, wield a weapon. He cannot protect himself. So Domavoy brought on his niece, who happened to be, like, this amazing Brazilian jiu-jitsu, like, you know, badass kind of girl, and she happens to be 12 as well. And yo, I didn't see this kid in a movie of about an hour 40 something minutes. I didn't see this kid. Like, her job was to protect the man. You would think that at least give me one scene. Just give me one scene with this child and her uncle fighting the giant, since that's, like, the main thing. I just wanted that. That's all I wanted. But we did not see this kid. All this kid did was run around. Like, she did not fight. She did not fight. All she did was run around. I'm like, why? And she, I think I only saw her in, like, three scenes or four at most. She wasn't utilized. I felt if you're going to give us a character that was already beautifully organized, actually give her a job to do. Like, have her say lines. She did not have any lines. Like, she just talked to Artemis once, and that was just it. I was not a fan of that. Then what else? The fight scene. Let's talk about the fight scene. It was trash. Nope, we are not here for it, Disney. It was trash. If you are going to, it just felt like a low-budget movie, but it's not low-budget, because this is Disney. This movie has been in the works for so long, and it just felt like nothing, like absolutely nothing. There was no, it was not, no oomph. Like, it was so bad, it was comical. I kid you not. There were some parts of the movie I actually laughed, because I was like, this cannot be, you cannot be giving me this to watch. This cannot be real, because it was so bad. Like, no, you had fighting scenes that, it's awful. You shouldn't do it. No, it just wasn't it. Now let's talk about costumes. Artemis's suit looked ill-fitting. I feel like from, like, the top part, it was good, it was okay, but, like, other than that, no. Other than that, it was not. Up top, it looked good, and I think his trousers weren't that bad, but, like, the sleeves were not his size. Like, it was ill-fitting. Then let's talk about, we already talked about the whole Mortigan's outfit. It looked like Hagrid. He looked like Hagrid. Like, he didn't know the beard, the brown outfit. It looked like Hagrid. We are not here for it. What else? I get Domavoy's whole outlook. His suit was properly fitted. It was okay. But his hair, I guess that was the whole point. Like, to make him look a little bit different. I get that. I was just not here for it. Now let's talk about the magical creatures costume. We are talking fairies, leprechauns, and you give them such an outfit. I mean, you had Judi Dench in that kind of outfit. That's preposterous. It did not make sense to me. I felt it was not properly made. It all looked like low quality to me. Now let's talk about the entire synopsis of this whole thing. This is a movie that basically came from a book. You know, usually when they make books into movies, it doesn't come out great. Not great, but at least it doesn't, like, come out the way you expected it to, especially if you've read the book. And that we've come to accept that, like, it's just normal. Your actual imagination is not going to play out the same way the directors and the film producers are going to lay out this movie. And that's okay. We've gotten used to that, right? But you had 8 I think there are 8 versions of the noodle. It's a series. There's like 8 parts to this whole thing, to the Atomic Fowl franchise. And you're telling me you cannot get better lines? The lines were whack in this movie. Like, I felt there was so much material and they could not, like, they didn't do it justice. It was just a shame to me. Like, this is Disney, for crying out loud. You have a good reputation. Very good. Please keep it so. Like, keep it that way. Give us good movies. Give us good quality. Give us good costume. Give us great actors. Like, I was not here for it. None of anything that happened in that time is foul was good. The only good thing I saw in that whole movie was the fact that it was so bad, it made me laugh. That's it. That's it for Artemis Fowl. In my opinion, it was not a great movie. Disney should have done better. It could have been better. I feel they had amazing source material. All they needed to have done was use it. That's it. And use a little bit of imagination with like every other thing. So that's it. If you stuck to this point, thank you very much for staying with me to this point. If you like this video and would like to see more of this type of video, please give this video a like, and please subscribe. I've realized that I don't tell you all to subscribe. I literally think people will. No. So I'm a firm believer of if you ask, you get. So I'm asking, if you like this video and want to see more, subscribe. Thank you very much. It was lovely to have sat down today with you guys, and I'll see you next time. Bye.